Hi everyone and welcome again to a new video. As promised in my last video related to upgrading to Windows 11, this video covers the easiest method to do a fresh install of Windows 11 and also covers how to do a dual boot where you have both Windows 10 and Windows 11 on your system and you can switch between both as desired. The previous videos I did related to Windows 11 were for unsupported hardware. For this video, I'll be using unsupported hardware as well, but the instructions are roughly the same for both supported and unsupported devices. Speaking of which, for today, I'll be once more using this lovely Dell Optiplex 9020. I plan to do an in-depth video on that one later and will put a card here when it's ready in case you're interested. The Dell currently has Windows 10 Pro installed, but the same works for a home edition as well. Actually, it has a home license in the BIOS. As you can see, we have a 4th generation Intel Core i5, which falls far beyond officially supported. Microsoft PC health check application tells us the same and also that we don't meet the TPM requirement. Let's get started with the preparation steps. This video, as mentioned, covers two ways of installing Windows 11, a fresh install and dual boot. A fresh install is where you remove everything that's currently on your PC, regardless of which version of Windows or other operating system currently installed, including all files and applications. A dual boot is where you keep your current Windows as it is right now, but alongside you add Windows 11. During boot time, you can then choose if you want to start Windows 10 or Windows 11. A third method to get to Windows 11 is an upgrade, where you bring your currently installed Windows 10 to Windows 11 and keep all settings, applications and data. That's covered in that earlier video which I mentioned, and I'll put a card here in case that's what you're looking for. For a dual boot, we first need to create a place to install Windows 11. For a fresh install, you can jump right to the next chapter, creating installation media, as we will be deleting all data anyway, and you can skip this step. As you can see, we have a single drive here, which is fully occupied for Windows 10 at the moment. The idea is to split that up in two pieces, one for Windows 10, the other for Windows 11. This can be done by disk management. You can start that tool by running disk MGMT from the start menu. Here we see that same single drive, which has three volumes already. The first one is the EFI volume, responsible for booting Windows. The second is the Windows 10 volume, which we saw in this PC earlier. And the last one is the recovery volume. The first and last can be used for Windows 11 as well. To split the Windows 10 volume, right-click on it and choose Shrink Volume. This action will take away some of the unused or free space of that volume and will keep all data that is there as is. Now we need to choose how much space to take away from that Windows 10 volume. Keep in mind that Windows 11 requires around 64-65 GB of free space, so you will need at least that amount. But also make sure you leave enough free space on the Windows 10 volume for it to keep functioning properly. I'll just take away around 100 GB from Windows 10 here. And click Shrink. As you can see, the Win10 volume got about 100 GB smaller and there is now about 100 GB of unallocated space on the disk. We'll create a volume there for Windows 11 by doing a right click and choosing New Simple Volume. Click Next. Keep things as they are to take all unallocated space for this volume. Assign the proposed drive letter and give the volume a label. I chose Win11 for clarity. Then click Next and finish. Now we can close this management and, as we would already see there, we now have two volumes. The C drive with Windows 10, which got smaller, and a new volume for Windows 11. Time for the next step, and that is to create installation media to boot from and to perform the installation. For this, you will need a USB drive of at least 8 GB. I inserted the USB drive and we can see it appearing here as drive G. We need to get the Windows 11 installation files on the drive and we'll be using the Windows 11 media creation tool to do that. The tool can be downloaded from Microsoft's website. This shouldn't take long, as it's a small tool. Then navigate to your Downloads folder and double-click on the downloaded file. Accept the license . Change the language if desired then click Next. Choose to write the files to a USB flash drive and click Next again. Make sure the right drive is chosen and once more click Next. The tool will now download the required files and write them to your USB drive. This can take some time, depending on your download speed and USB drive's write speed, of course. That went fine, and we can close this tool. As you can see, our USB drive now has all the needed files. You might be tempted here to go and delete the appraiser.sdll file in the sources folder, which is the method I used to perform an upgrade on unsupported hardware in my previous video. Unfortunately, this doesn't work for a fresh install or a dual boot. We'll be using a different trick so we can leave the USB drive just as it is here. Alright, time to use that USB drive and boot from it. To do so, we need to reboot the PC first, and when the BIOS comes up, configure it to use the USB drive as the first boot device, or press a key to select a temporary boot device. On this Dell, this is the F12 key. F8 is often used as well, but it really depends on the system you have. Here I'll select my USB drive in order to boot the Windows installer from it. In the first screen, select the desired language settings and click Next. At this point, in case you have a supported CPU, TPM 2.0 and secure boot, in short a supported PC for Windows 11, you can just click Install Now. If you have unsupported hardware, like this Dell I'm using currently, there are a few additional steps to take to overcome the hardware check. To accomplish this, press Shift F10 while at the screen. This should bring up a command prompt. Here, start the registry editor by typing regedit and press Enter. In the registry editor, navigate to HKEY Local Machine, System, Setup. On the Setup folder, right-click and choose New, Key, and give it the name labconfig. In your new key labconfig, right-click and choose New DWORD 32-bit. Give the DWORD the name bypass TPM check. Pay attention that it's exactly as in the video. Repeat the process and choose again New DWORD 32-bit. This time, give the name bypass secure boot check. Again, make sure the name matches exactly as I have. Then double-click on each of the variables and set the value to 1 in order to enable them. This is how it should look like. Make sure you did this in the right location, so HKEY Local Machine, System, Setup, Labconfig. Then we can close the registry editor and exit the command prompt. Now we can continue with the installation, so click on Install Now. Accept the license agreement and choose for custom install here. We've came to the point where we need to select where to install Windows 11. Here things again are slightly different for a fresh install or a dual boot. First for a dual boot. You can see a similar layout of the drive here as we saw in disk management. We have the volume called Win10, which has our currently installed Windows 10, and the volume which we created before called Win11. So this is the one which we need to select, and then click Next. For a fresh install, we can simply remove all the current volumes one by one. You could create a new one yourself, but just selecting the whole drive and clicking Next is fine. The installer will do the necessary. From here, things are the same again. Files are getting copied and the installation continues. The computer will eventually restart, and for a dual boot, you will start to see the option to choose which version of Windows to start. After some more patience, you should end up with the following dialog, where we need to select our location and keyboard layout. And eventually, we need to give a name to our PC. This results in another reboot. When the PC comes back, the wizard or dialogue continues. Here we need to add an account to the PC. If you have a Microsoft account and want to use it to log in, you can just continue the login process here. I, on the other hand, prefer an offline account. Now to use that instead of a Microsoft account is a bit different between a home or a pro version of Windows. As I mentioned in the beginning, this PC has a key for Windows Home in the BIOS, so that's what got installed. The easiest method to get an offline account is to disconnect your Ethernet cable or Wi-Fi, if that's the case, and then click this back arrow. As you can see, that allows you to create an offline account in Home. For the Pro version, you can leave the cable in and just click on Sign In Options and simply choose for an offline account here. In the last step, we still need to configure some settings, mainly related to privacy. And after clicking Accept, we are in the last stage of the installation. Our patience gets rewarded with a fresh Windows 11 desktop on our PC. Let me first put back that Ethernet cable. And also remove the USB drive, which we don't need anymore. Okay, so far so good. Let's have a look at about this PC. Still the same hardware, of course, but Windows 11 is running on it now. Next, let's check if updates are working. Seems like that's the case, and it's also good to see that Windows Update will take care of some missing drivers for us. Let's get these installed. And we're back. In case you did a fresh install, you're basically done here and you can start using your system and enjoy your clean Windows 11 installation. If you did a dual boot install, let me still show you how to switch between the different installations, Windows 10 and 11 in my case, and how to choose which to start by default. In Windows 11, go to About This PC, then choose the Advanced System Settings link in the middle of the dialog. Then in System Properties, select Startup and Recovery. Here we can choose which operating system starts by default. Let me change it to Windows 10. And here we can also configure the time you get for you to choose during boot. Let me change that to 10 seconds just to demonstrate. Now, if we reboot the system, you can see that Windows 10 is selected by default and it gets booted after 10 seconds, exactly as we configured it. You can also see that the dual boot system works just as we wanted. And from Windows 10, we can access those settings in the same way. Through About This PC, Advanced System Settings, Startup and Repair. Let me change the default here back to Windows 11. And another reboot. You can see Windows 11 is getting selected as default again. From here, you can also just use the arrow keys to make a choice. And if you go to Change Defaults, you can also change the default choice and timer from here as well. That's all I had to cover on this topic. Hopefully this helps you to get a fresh or dual boot install of Windows 11 working on your PC. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. Let me and other viewers know how this worked for you in the comments as well, and If you're interested in more of the same, definitely subscribe to the channel. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.